The topic today is, as you can see on the screen, it is GST demand on differential income upon reconciliation between GSTR and RTR. Is it the topic that it suits the issue which we have been discussing in our earlier discussion? Generally, we talk of balance sheet and order. Generally, we talk of difference in the balance sheet and profit and loss account. But they are also part of IPR only. So that's why I have to make a symmetry between GSTR and ITR and this work. Basically, what was happening in service tax time that most of the demands were issued on the basis of difference between 26 years. Most of the demands during service tax time, they had a reason. On account of difference between 26 years, because given in 26 years, and the ST3 returns. Now it is the GSTR returns and the balance sheet account. So audit objections are frequently raised in this reconciliation. What we are demanding is income in excess of that stated in GSTR. Presumed to be taxable under GST. Am I correct? This is the most of the audit. These are the resumed to this point. Okay, well, there is no section or rule under CGST, IGST Act which authorizes. What is the authority? What is the charging section? As you know, whenever there is a tax statute, there will be a charging section which authorizes the officers who derive their powers under that act to levy a tax. Under Customs Act, it is Section 12. Here it is Section 9. The difference between here and Customs Act is that in the Customs Act, the taxing event is clearly identified. The moment any goods are brought from outside India into India, the importation tax. The definition of importation is anything goods from outside India to India. So the moment goods have landed, taxing event has taken place, that is paid. But here, particularly when the goods are, there is no goods which is intangible, like the service. Services are intangible. So to pinpoint exactly at what point of time the taxing event has taken place is difficult. As you see, Section 9 is there on the screen. There self will levy the tax. So, my way, the charging section will always start in whatever tax law you need, there self will levy the tax more than this. Customs Act will be assigned. All the central goods and service tax on all intrastate supplies of goods or services. That means there should be a supply. And the value is determined under Section 15. Tax can be demanded only when supplies over and above that reflected in the GSTR 3B, 9, and 9C. I have not written all the returns. But so all the amounts which are reflected in the GSTR, in the service 3B is a monthly document. So you will total all the 12 GSTR 3B. Then GSTR 9 gives you a sum total of all the figures. So you can demand tax, but you have to know that which are the supply over and above what is stated in India. Similarly, Section 5 of IGST, which authorizes to levy IGST over interstate supply, there it is intra. Now this Section 15, Section 15 will be Section 15 of the Act. Again here, the value of a supply, of course, so there should be a supply. Send me the transaction. Now the transaction should be identified. As I said, the Customs Act, the point of taxation is identified. Here also, when the invoice is issued by a supplier of goods, it is clearly identifiable. But In the case of intangible goods, you may have difficulty to establish that at what point of time that supply was in. And the value, how the value is determined, price is actually paid or paper. So then the next thing is the auditor has to establish that some price has been paid. That means from the account of one person, the money has come to another. So that money trail has to be established. So value of supplies have improved, what taxes, duties, etc. Any amount that the supplier is liable to pay in relation to such supply, but which has been incurred by the recipient of the supply and not included in the price actually paid or paid. So that is also the value of supply. And incidental expenses including commission and packing charges. So go back to the first slide. So basically, charging section is section 9, and when you charge a tax, you will certainly charge on certain value. So value you will get from section 15. That's why we thought to read that section. Next slide. Now you see, value of supply service transaction value. Transaction driven value is the price actually paid or payable, where the supplier and recipient are not related. Price is the sole consideration for the supplier. And section 7 is defines the scope of supply. That's what is the scope of supply? Supply can be through sale, transfer, barter, exchange, license, rental, lease, disposal, anything which is agreed to be done. For a consideration by a person, in the course of occurrence of business. Now, income under income tax law is determined for the whole financial year as per profit and loss account and is not levied on transaction basis. That is, invoice, delivery challan, debit note, even bill. These are the documents on the basis of which then you can charge GST. Any other document anybody can point out? On which GST can be levied? और कोई है तो ये चाली क्रेडिट नोट इसमें नहीं आएगा क्रेडिट नोट पर जीएसटी नहीं लगेगा रिवर्स तो जीएसटी लेते होने की ट्रांजेक्शन सेटिस्फाइंग द डेफिनेशन ऑफ इट हैज नथिंग टू डू विद द प्रॉफिट और लॉस ऑफ द बिजनेस सो सिंस यू आर टैक्सिंग एवरी ट्रांजेक्शन At that point of time, nobody knows whether a transaction will lead to a profit or to a loss. But taxation has to be made a component of that. If 100 rupees is the value, 80 rupees is the tax, 100 again. That is the last or so that. So the difference between the two is that income is derived after the operations of the whole year. It can be a loss also. But here you have to charge every economic activity. Whenever the activity has taken place, this is important in that context. When there is a differential amount between the two documents, income tax documents and GST documents, then on that amount, you have to establish that whether any supply had taken place. If it had taken place, what was the value of supply? At what point of time that supply had taken? From whose account the money has come to taxpayer's account? Unless money trail is established, demand will not sustain before a court. Next. What are the factors leading to difference in demonstration? I have identified some factors. I will be happy if anybody adds to that. Income can be on account of sale of consumable property, securities, mutual funds, interest on FD, settlement of insurance claims, transfer of business as a going concern. Pura business is transferred. License premium receipts like NEIS, BFI and other export fee disappear schemes. Foreign exchange fluctuation income on account of duty drawback, salary balance retail. इसके अलावा और कुछ आप लोगों के mind में आता होगा बताएंगे तो मैं बाद में इसको ऐड करूंगा पॉइंट तो सब क्या है, एवरी ग्रुप इज रेजिंग दिस पॉइंट एंड सम हाउ आई एम आई गॉट कंफर्टेबल फ्रॉम द डे वन विद दिस वन. तो इसमें से आई विल बी हैप्पी इफ इन द जनरल ग्रुप भी किसी के माइंड में आता हो तो डाल देना, तो आई विल ऐड इन माय एंड. अब ये सब करने का लोग थोड़े क्यों इतना मेहनत कर रहे हैं, उसका फायदा ये होगा ऑलरेडी है, एक दो जगह से वो ये बोलने के लिए इन्विटेशन है कोई डेड बॉडी से या कोई यंग एडवोकेट्स का एक भी बार काउंसिल ऑफ महाराष्ट्र है जो है उदय सिंह की जो न्यू इन्फ्लुएंस है लॉ के उनको एड्रेस कर. तो ये सब रेडीमेड है काम आ जाए और आप लोगों के सामने खुला हुआ है, किसी ने इसका ऑब्जेक्शन नहीं किया तो सही ही होगा, नहीं भी मान नहीं सकता. नेक्स्ट दीज आर द केस दिस पुश कंस्ट्रक्शन अभी हाइपरवेंटिल ये ऑर्डर अभी जो वर्तमान मुद्दे में आए हैं अनिल सक्करवाल साहब ये अभी मेंबर बन गया है मुंबई के सी ये जो पास किया था उस समय वो अहमदाबाद में थे कानपुर में इलाहाबाद में थे इंसिडेंट की वी हैव वर्क टुगेदर इन औरंगाबाद हिमाज एडिशनल कमिश्नर हिमाज डी सी बैठ गए अहमदाबाद का कोई है आप फिर सुन अब इसमें देखिए ये जजमेंट बाद में है सुप्रीम कोर्ट के लिए अपील हुआ इस अपील वाज अलाउड बाई सिस्टर रीजनल जज इलाहाबाद इसके आगे शायद होगा इस That time in service time, time most of the objection was that your figures in the 26 years. Now 26 years is a different document. उसमें जो जिस व्यक्ति ने वो बिजनेस कर रहा है बिजनेस का डॉक्यूमेंट है ना तो जिस कंसर्न ने जिस बिजनेस इंटिटी ने बिजनेस डिडक्ट किया है उसका पूरा डिटेल रहा है. सो 26 years ये बेसिस पे अगर आप सर्विस टैक्स या जी एस टी का डिमांड करना चाहते हैं तो फिर भी आसान है बिकॉज आपको वो बंदा दिख रहा है इसके जिसने वो टीडीएस काटा है. अभी आपकी दिक्कत ये है कि डिफरेंशियल इनकम तो आपको मिल गए लेकिन अब उसका कोई डॉक्यूमेंट नहीं है कि वो इनकम कहाँ है. ये हो सकता है चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स हैव एक्सेप्टेड दे हैव बीन कन्फाइडेड टू मी दैट ऐसा कोई नहीं ये नहीं बता सकता है बट ये लोगों ने भी उसमें कुछ जब उनको दोनों साथ टैली नहीं होना होता है तो कुछ अमाउंट डाल देते हैं 30,000, 25,000, 50,000, 1,00,000 कोई अमाउंट कुछ डाल देते हैं पहले लिखा उसका प्रॉब्लम है आरोप बट दे जॉन मान को भी दिल कि हमने ये डाल दिया बिकॉज अकाउंट नहीं करने वाला बट डिस्पाइट दैट इनकम टैक्स कैन अराइज ऑन दैट अमाउंट But GST cannot rise because unless we have proved that who is the person who has paid the money for what service or for what is the next. अल्फा मैनेजमेंट में भी सिमिलर वही था इनकम टैक्स रिटर्न के बेसिस पे आप डिमांड नहीं कर सकते इसमें सर लास्ट में लिखा हुआ है वन ऑफ द टू जजमेंट्स है बट फाइनली एजुकेटेड बाय द डिपार्टमेंट बिफोर सुप्रीम कोर्ट एंड सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑल्सो रिकॉर्डेड तो लॉ हैज अचीव्ड फाइनलिटी इन सर्विस टैक्स रेजिम Many of our officers are aware, but now they have an argument to say you want to service tax of the GST. But pura service tax ke hi provision isme laya gaya. So aisa koi fundamental difference nahi hai. Agar khali tax ka naam change ho gaya, that does not mean that anything that we will have changed because the business model is same. Their suppliers are same, their buyers, vendors are same. So only the name of the tax has changed. Keep it. Last slide. Yeah. These are the other judgments. which have to be taken. These are all three staff cases and they all have to, they always have to satisfy the matter because abhi to so far notice issue wala shuru hua hai, shuru hua hai jail ki. So after 2-3 years certainly some judgment will come. But I am not sure whether even after the judgment we will stop